Excuse me, sir. May I have my glasses back?
Huh? Oh, yeah. Here you go. Cereza, how did you get such magical glasses?
The glasses aren't magic, silly. I can see the monsters without them.
Monsters? Not quite. So, has Bayonetta, I mean your mom, been fighting these big bad monsters for a long time?
Mummy is a witch, and witches protect people and are very strong. When I grow up, I'll be strong too, and I'll protect my mummy.
Wait, you think witches do what? No, forget it. No point in arguing with a little kid. I'll manage on my own.
I'm sure you will.
Mummy!
Shit!
You never cease to amuse me, Cheshire. I suppose that's your next target? This is yours, little one. You didn't cry while I was gone, did you?
Nope.
Good.
Bayonetta, no matter how I ask, no matter how many times, you always say the same thing.
Come now, Kitty. You know it was
a
all
misunderstanding.
Just...
You're so stubborn, you know that? My father, he was a journalist too. In fact, he was twice the man I could ever hope to be. He was obsessed with one case his entire career. A case so bizarre it took over his life. They could have made a movie of the details. The followers of darkness, the Umbra Witches, and their light world counterparts, the Lumen Sages, controlling everything with a power known as the Eyes of the World. Then, the Light and Dark Clans suddenly disappeared from their medieval home in Europe. You may be familiar with the town. You're standing in it. Welcome to Vigrid. 500 years later.
500 years.
Each clan, working at the behest of the powers that be, sought to lead their fractured world towards peace. They both possessed an eye said to have the power to create history that they used to oversee the world. However, their spirit of cooperation did not last. For amongst them, a pair of young star-crossed lovers conceived a child that sent the clans on a path to ruin. The woman was thrown in jail, and the man exiled from his clan. However, the child remained with the Umbra, raised as a black sheep even amongst the darkness. Since the balance between light and dark had been lost, both clans spiraled into decay. Legend had it that the two eyes could be united to control reality itself. And this legend fueled ambition and desire, leading to a myriad of battles between the clans. In fact, it led to their mutual destruction. My father was mocked for buying such a fairy tale. However, I believed his story, and I believe it more than ever now that I've found you. The memory of the clan lingers on, despite the passing of 500 years. What on earth was my father searching for? And why did he have to die for it? I have to discover the truth with my own eyes. That's why I haven't given up my chase for it. Or you. The head of the Ithaval Group, the multinational that dominates Vigrid, recently tried to sell an enormous gemstone on the black market. If he isn't selling out in the open, it means we're going to have to acquire it by other means. And that starts by sneaking onto that jet.
Mummy, are you looking for something?
I am.
How did you lose it?
Little one, do you have anything you really like? Something really important to you?
Yes, this. I love it.
Where did you get this?
You gave it to me, Mummy, for my birthday.
When you love something, never lose it. Understand, little one? You must keep it safe, close to your heart.
Thank you.
to your old self, are we? Why so glum? Something troubling you?
Only your constant fretting over my state of affairs. I've no time to play games with you.
No need to take out your stress on me, Bayonetta. It's clear you're worried for the girl.
She is. Now.
My, aren't we attached to our precious little one? Do you like it when she calls you Mummy?
You're absolutely delusional. If I leave her, he'll never shut up about it. And his whining is twice as irritating as anything the child could muster.
You've quite the tongue when it comes to curling round the truth.
And what about you? What are you hiding? Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think these might mean something to you.
I've no need for worthless junk.
I am well aware of my task, but you have forgotten that I do not need your help.
It seems your little friend is gone forever. Fill them. Fill your eyes with hatred. Accept your violent fate. Accept it and earn the left eye. Prove you deserve it.
He'll kick! Yeah!
your fear.
Not yet. She isn't ready. Cockroaches or crying babies. Time to go, little one. Hold on tight, okay?
Okay.
Yeah!
It's okay, little one. I'll be right back.
Mommy!
Mommy! I am Malfi. General Amor Kozis Laush Gorgona.
Another talkative type. I don't think I've got time to entertain your blather. I'd much rather hear it straight from your boss. The witch hunts.
Rest, I think.
Thank you.
I have no idea why you would want this stone. It would look absolutely terrible on you. Much too flashy. Welcome aboard, Cheshire.
Oh, fucking hell!
Mummy!
I told you I'd be right back. Shouldn't you be, you know, flying this thing? I'm a bit occupied at the moment.
Mummy!
Well, so much for the subtle approach. We might as well have speakers on this thing blaring Ride of the Fucking Valkyries.
Come now, we're VIPs. You know, nothing says you've made it in life like a private helicopter.
Then welcome aboard Air Luca, Flight 001. This is your captain, Luca, speaking. Fasten your safety belts, as this may be a bumpy flight. You're really not going to like what comes next. I hope you know that.
Don't tell me. Air Cheshire has awful in-flight entertainment and horrendous food.
Think about it. Those things that downed the jet aren't just going to let us land on their island. You think we can just say, "Hey, we're here," and they'll bring us a cake? Things look good from up here. But the further down you go, the harder it is to not notice the reality of things.
Cheshire, look.
Oh, I'm looking. Oh, fuck me.
Welcome to my fantasy zone.
Get ready.
Yeah! Welcome to Isla del Sol, island of wealth and power. Jean, if you've made it this far, that should be enough. You're back to your old self. This is where we finish what was started so long ago. A friend of my enemy is also my enemy. Be it witch or sage. The Lumen Sages. They were our counterbalance as overseers. Between us, there was a law that was never to be broken. It stated that the intersection of light and dark would bring calamity to this earth. But 500 years ago, a child was born in clear violation of this tenet. That child was you. 500 years ago. The disaster this caused sent the clans into a spiral of chaos that continues to be felt to this day. You, the half-breed of light and dark, are at the center of that chaos. Allowing you to continue to exist is a danger that cannot be accepted. When the eyes of the world are within our grasp, the power of creation will be awakened. That is why the left eye, our treasured left eye, will never fall into the hands of another. The left eye, our treasured left eye, will never fall into the hands of another. Bayonetta, it is time that this is brought to an end. That you are brought to an end.
You did it. It is our charge as witches to protect the treasures of the clan by any means necessary, even if it means burning every inch of this island to a crisp.
I'm really beginning to hate missiles. You know, I have no idea what the hell you girls got going on here. But you don't mind if I take this off your hands, do you? Get in, Cerecita.
Mommy?
Bayonetta, time is of the essence. This can wait no longer. Heel kick! Heel kick! Never!
I've got it.
Now it's decided. So it is. The fear is still not gone from your eyes. Fear? The memories you've held for 500 years are the source of your fear. They cloud your vision. But now, you've accepted your fate. That is how you bested me. That is why you possess the most beloved of Umbran treasures. That is why you possess the left eye. We fought for this stone, and because of it, everyone died. That gem brings back so many memories. That is why the left eye, our treasured left eye, will never fall into the hands of another. I will not stand for the wild ambition of a treacherous Lumen sage who disrupted our age-old balance. Your path ends here! Do not fear your fate! Stand, Theresa! In the innocence of our childhood, we used to play together, as friends. But as time passed, perhaps even my eyes were clouded with fear. We were. Do not fear your fate. Stand, Theresa. Stand and open your eyes. For with every truth, there is another one to be seen.
Hey, is it over? What? It's not like you don't scare the shit out of me all the time.
Theresa. I don't know whether to shoot you or to take you to Vegas for good luck, Cheshire.
Give me more credit than that. If you must know where L-U-K-A Luca is concerned, there's no such thing as luck. Only skill. You didn't expect me to trust bitches. I mean, witches, did you, Bayonetta?
How's the little one?
Out like a light. But okay other than that. What about you? You really think I'm gonna let myself be seen in public with a girl looking all beat up like that?
Ooh. I look dreadful, do I?
Huh?
You'll have to learn to wipe that stupid look off your face, or I'll never let you keep chasing me around this world. Got that? Luca?
Now that's more like it.
Hurry! Yeah! We'll be right back.